There is perhaps no better demonstration of the folly of human conceits than this distant image of our tiny world.
To me, it underscores our responsibility to deal more kindly with one another and to preserve and cherish the pale blue dot, the only home we've ever known.
Today we honor Felix Adler, a young radical who had the audacity to found a new religion, one grounded in ethics and reaching toward high ideals. He addressed a new community and challenged his listeners to make clear the responsibilities which our nature as moral beings imposes upon us in view of the political and social evils of our age. The time calls for action, Adler said. We are rooted in ethics and we reach for the high ideals, the supreme concern of personal relationships. He said, we mean life. That life which you can only find in and through the life of others, through the radiation that goes out from you into him or her, and that comes back to you. That is the central truth of ethical culture. It is in the moral experience that the life that goes out from me goes into you, and that your moral experience radiates from you into me. On a personal note, I came to the Brooklyn Society for Ethical Culture looking for a place where my Jewish husband and my Catholic self could find common ground and could celebrate our diversity, which extended far beyond our religious upbringing. And we wanted a home for our children. I think I finally grasped Felix Adler and appreciated him when I read something he wrote about raising children. We should teach our children nothing that they will need to unlearn. How much unlearning have we done in our lives about so very many things? But we should communicate to them and pass on to them the treasures, the best of our age and our life. And so it was with that that I think I finally became an ethical culturist. We all need to define ethical culture for ourselves. It is our moral experience which is essential to the ethical movement.
I was asked to represent the Ethical Society at a mass meeting on Ferguson, a major interfaith gathering featuring as the keynote speaker Dr. Cornel West. Now you can probably imagine, and I see from your response, you know who that is. I was kind of proud and excited to receive an invitation to this event. Now, I've spoken in many places before, many different crowds, but this felt different. I felt a weight of responsibility. I was representing my community, my worldview, at a time when human dignity was at stake. I felt that in the midst of all these potent religious messages, someone had to speak for our common humanity and remind everybody that the work of securing justice is our work and cannot be left to God. If there is to be salvation for humankind, I said, it will be because we save ourselves. Our job is to find ways to use the ethical energy created in our communities to change the world. That's the purpose of ethical humanism to me. The purpose of our movement is to be a constant reminder, not just inside our societies, but out on the streets, that people matter, whatever your culture may suggest, whatever your scripture may decree, whatever your God might command, people matter. All people, all the time. We look to each other, finding succor and solace, insight and inspiration, passion and power in humanity itself. We are the ones we've been waiting for.
We are the ones. We are the ones.